Hello everyone, today we will be solving problem B from Code Forces round 539. For detailed problem statement, follow the link in the description. So what the problem wants to say is, we are given an array, okay, so if n is 5, that means we are given an array of size 5. Say the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, so this is the array that we are given with. So what is the cost? They have defined the cost as sum of all the elements of the array. Okay, so in this case, if you take the array like this only, so what is the cost? It is 5 into 6 by 2, which is basically sum of n natural numbers, so which gives you 15. Okay, so this is how they have defined the cost. Now you can do one operation. What is? You can select any two elements from this array and you can change one element. As say there are two elements are I and j, you can change I as I into x and change j as j divided by x. So what do I mean by that? Say I selected two elements 3 and 4. I selected these two elements 3 and 4. Now what I can do is, I can change this 4 by 4 by 2, and at the same time I need to change this 3 as 3 into 2. Okay, so what this is going to be, this will change to 6 and this will change to 2. So likewise, what is going to be the sum this time? If you do this, then your sum is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 5, which is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 16. Okay. Now your objective is to change this array in such a way that this cost function is minimized. This is what they want you to do. It's like, find such a pair and a value x such that you can minimize this cost. So how many unknowns you have? You need to find two elements. Let me call that I and j. These two elements you need to find, plus you need to find an element x and x. Okay, these three are the unknowns that we need to find. Now one more constraint on this x is, when you are trying to divide this element, so this was x, right? Here in this case x was 2. Now when you are trying to divide, now this x should be a divisor, that means the remainder should be 0. Means I can choose 2 here as x when I am trying to divide 4 by some x. I can choose 1 as x, but I can't choose 3 as x because 4 by 3 is not leaving 0 as the remainder. When I do 4 modulo 3, it is not 0. So I need a proper divisor here. Okay. So this was another constraint given. So we have 3 unknowns and we need to find. One good observation to make is, whenever you will try to find an element in which you will multiply x, right? We have two elements, one we are dividing x, in the other one we are multiplying x. So the one in which you will multiply, the optimal approach is to select the minimum element. Why? Because if you choose any other element, the cost is going to be more. So the best approach is to choose the minimum element to get the multiplication factor. Okay, so from this I and j, if I call this I to be the one in which I am going to multiply, so I know this I is going to be my minimum element. Okay, so if this array is A, then minimum element in A is going to be my I. Now we are left with only J and X. Okay, so once I find this minimum element, I can loop for this J. Why? Because the number of elements in the array was given to be of order of 5 into 10 to the power 4. So I can loop into this. Now we still have another unknown factor x. Now ai was given to be maximum 100. So for each of these possible values, I can check for all the possible values of x as well. So when you check out all the possible values for j and x, it will result in a complexity of order 10 to the power 6 only. So you can do this, and once we are done with that, we will calculate the answer for each of the possible combinations and will return the minimum one. So how we'll do this? First, we do sorted A. So in this step I am sorting, okay. Now I am saying that my minimum element is going to be the first element as I am sorting it in increasing order. So my this minimum element thing is done. Now to get the second element in which I will divide, I need to range from I is equals to 1 till n minus 1. So one other way to write that is, for I in range 1 to n. So this is Python notation. So this is basically running a loop from I is equals to 1 till n minus 1, that is less than is equals to n minus 1. Okay. Now these are all the, if I write it as j, it will be more visually easy to see that I am looking for this j. Okay. Now what I need to do when I am looking for this j, in each of these j's I need to select all the possible values of x. What are all the possible values of x? For x in range 1, 2, say like a of j plus 1, I need to consider all the possible values. But one more thing to check is that whether the remainder left is 0 or not, right? So if my present element was a of j modulo x equals to 0, that means x divides a of j with leaving no remainder. That means it's a valid x that we can choose here. So now I will calculate what my answer would have been if I divide this a of j by this current x and multiply the minimum element into x. Okay. So how we'll do that? We need the sum initially, right? So let us say that we have sum of a which has sum of all elements of A. So in sum of A, I have stored the sum of all the elements of A. It doesn't matter whether you do it before sorting or after sorting, sum is going to remain the same only. So how will I calculate the new answer? Okay. So new answer is going to be my sum of A minus, what will I subtract? I will subtract a of 0, which is basically minimum element, minus I will subtract a of j, because these two elements are not there, right? Because when we calculated this sum, 3 and 4 were not there. So I'm subtracting minimum element minus a of j. I've subtracted those two, and what I need to add? Plus minimum element into this x. Okay, the minimum element that I have chosen, I will multiply it by x, and the other element, which is my aj in this case, I will do aj by x. So this is my new answer. Now when will I update my answer? If this new answer is less than my present answer. So what is my present answer? Initially, I will take this sum of A as my present answer only. Okay. So what I can write before only is answer is equals to sum of A. I will start with that because I am given with that and I may not change anything. Then only if I have the minimum cost, so I will start with that only. So now, once I am done with this, now if, or I can directly write minimum. So my answer is going to be minimum of answer and new answer. So this was all about this problem. For implementation details, check the link in the description. Happy coding.